Hi, this is Bishop Clark, and welcome again to another broadcast of Words to Live By. We're going to go back in for the conclusion of this message, how to have a happy home when you're single. Boy, what a mighty, mighty word the Lord has been sharing with us. Let's tune in and hear what else God has to say.
1 Corinthians. Now, if what I was saying didn't make sense, it's about to right now. 1 Corinthians chapter 7. You got 1 Corinthians chapter 7? I want to look at verse 32. Listen to this. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 32. But I want you to be without care. He or she who is unmarried cares for the things of the Lord, how he or she may please the Lord. Watch this. This is going to blow your mind. Turn to him and say, neighbor, your mind's about to get blown. Here's what Paul says. If you're going to be happy as a single, you've got to get your God-given goal. You've got to start removing yourself from some practices and people. But then watch this. You've got to learn to occupy your mind, watch this, with him as a priority. Now, you got to catch this. You got to catch this. This is so powerful. When I studied this passage, I realized that one of the reasons why you all will think that I'm a decent preacher and I'm an okay feeder is because in the midst of all that I've been through in life, the Lord, by his grace, amen, has allowed me to allow this scripture to become paramount. He says, the person who is unmarried, let's look at it again. Verse 32. Cares for the things of the Lord, how he or she may please the Lord. Watch this. Here it is. Paul says, if you're single, the only thing that should be on your mind is how can I put a smile on God's face? Let that marinate for a minute. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, if you're unmarried, the only thing that should be on your mind is how can I put a smile on God's face? For those who are married, the instructions are, how can I put a smile on God's face? Well, how do you say that? Because before you're married, you're single. And how can I put a smile on my mate's face? In that order. Now, you got that? Unmarried, only person I got to worry about putting a smile on face is God. Married, I got to worry about putting a smile on God's face and my mate's face. Now watch how it works. Watch how it works. Watch how it works. Single. Now I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying. But I got children. I got a job. I got a family. And I don't want to insult you, and God knows I don't want to offend you. But all of that stuff you got, probably because you didn't start out doing it the way God wanted you to. You missed that, huh? Okay. It's hard to occupy your mind with putting a smile on God's face when you haven't gotten a God-given goal. When you started your single life, if you are not in search of what God wanted you to do, then it's hard for you to put a smile on his face because that ain't what you used to doing. Well, what about those who are married? It's hard to put a smile on your mate's face when you haven't learned to put a smile on God's face. Watch this. Because God, remember, is the one that allowed you to find the mate if you were focusing on your goal. Am I making any sense? Y'all, I feel as though y'all are lost here. Let me give it to you as plain as I possibly can. When you don't do life the way God wants you to do it, you automatically have complications. And for the most part, we spend most of our lives trying to work through the complications and never getting around to living the way God wanted us to live. So it's always trying to get back. No, I'm sorry. It's always trying to stay on track to get back because we were never where we were supposed to be. Am I making any sense to you? Single, your whole essence. Well, I got children. Why? And I'll tell you why. Come on, let's go on and be honest. We all grown. Because somewhere down the line, we went outside of the will to have them. Now you're looking at me crazy, mother. No. See, you can't ever fix nothing if you don't deal with it correctly. Children were supposed to be the result of those who are married. Well, I was married, but I got divorced. Okay, let's look at that. Marriage supposed to be between people who are compatible. So anyway, you dice it or slice it, it comes back to us not doing it the way God wanted us to originally doing it. Turn to your neighbor. We mess up because we don't stick to the original plan. That's where, okay, you can get that. Thank you, God. When you don't follow the original plan, there's always complication. And everything God does in your life and everything God does in my life is to get us back to the original plan.